In this video, we'll describe various strategies to remove surface mold in a boat. We'll take apart a dehumidifier and show the details of how it works, and we'll walk through a practical solution to overwintering a boat in locations where moisture is a serious problem. If you've grown tired of using bleach compounds to wipe surface mold off of your boat, then this video is for you. Now, one option you have is to buy big buckets of desiccant, and you pour that desiccant into containers like this, and then you change that out every few days. In my experience, that's next to useless. Now, one of the most common strategies is to deal with it the same way we deal with mold in the home. You raise the ambient temperature so that you never get below the dew point. You see, warm air has a lot lower relative humidity than cold air, and so if you can prevent the temperature from dipping below the dew point overnight, you're less likely to get condensation and mold. The problem with that strategy is that in a boat, you've got nowhere to push that air. There are no fans to blow air outside of the boat, and if you do add some kind of a fan, then you're going to constantly be chasing your tail with having to heat cold air, incoming air, and it's going to end up being expensive over the long term. Now, we race every couple of weeks, and so we've got a constant flux of lines and sails that need to be dried out before the next session. This is our solution here. We use a standard room dehumidifier. I'll show you how I modified it, a little bit about how it works. Okay, I've taken this dehumidifier apart just for you to show you how it is, and I hope I can convey to you how interesting this whole thing is. Now give me 3 minutes of your time and you'll be able to understand how a beer fridge works, how a regular fridge works, how your air conditioner works in your car, how the heat pump in your house works. They all work the same. Now let's talk about the dehumidifier first. Air comes in here and that air hits these cold fins. And when it hits these cold fins, dew forms on the fins and it collects down into that tray right there. Do you see that tray? And that's the liquid that we're trying to get out of the boat. And so we'll talk about what we're going to do with that later. But let's come over here. And you can see there are two sets of coils. These are the evaporator coils. And these are the condenser coils. And in contrast with a normal fridge, these things are back to back because this device is optimized for collection of fluid and not for generation of heat or cooling. Now come around here, we can see two motors. Here's the fan, and that fan blows warm air out the back. Warm, dry air comes out the back, and this is the compressor. And both of these motors are what we call permanent split capacitor AC induction motors. And around here is the brains of the system. You can see there's a board in the back, and you can see there's a large capacitor, and you gotta be careful you can get a nasty shock even after it's unplugged. Now that actually has two capacitors in one for the fan and one for the compressor. Now let's talk about how this thing works. Here's the compressor here, and its locked rotor amperage is 29 amps, and it runs on 410A refrigerant. And that's a classic old style refrigerant. And this gas is compressed down, and as it's compressed down, it gets really hot. So this tube here should be really hot when it's running. And it's compressed gas coming through here, and it gets to this point here, and you can see there's a high pressure cutout switch, and so you've got compressed gas here going into the condenser. And the purpose of the condenser is to condense that gas into a liquid. And so out the bottom comes liquid. And that liquid hits this tiny tube. You see that tiny tube right there? That's called a capillary tube. You can see it's coiled around a few times. Now the idea behind the capillary tube is to provide some resistance to flow. And with resistance, it's like a constriction, like an orifice. And so when you, for instance, when you squeeze a canned air, it gets really cold. Well, the same thing happens here. When it goes through this constriction, on the other side is really low pressure. And at that really low pressure, that liquid no longer wants to be a liquid anymore. It wants to boil into a gas, but it boils at a really cold temperature. And so in the evaporator right here, you've got evaporation going on inside the fins, and outside the fins, you've got condensation of dew. And so that liquid, once it's gone back into, evaporated back into a gas, you can see there's a temperature meter here, back into a gas, and it goes to this device right here. And that thing there is called an accumulator. And the purpose of the accumulator is to prevent any liquid from going into the compressor, because if you get liquid in the compressor, it can kill the compressor. And so you get this room temperature gas going into the compressor, and the cycle starts itself again. Fascinating. So all dehumidifiers will have some kind of a bucket that collects the water, and this is the bucket here. It's got a little handle on it, and when it fills up with water, you just pour it out and then start again. And it has a little float switch. You can see that right there? And that float switch allows you to, it shuts the machine off if you don't come in and drain it. Now the problem is you don't want to have to go to your boat every day and drain this fluid off, and so you need to have some kind of mechanism to drain the fluid into a sink rather than draining into the bucket. I'll show you how to do that now.
So here's this little spigot here. Let me show you. It's right up there. We're gonna put a hose on the end of that and put that into the sink. So the solution in this device is to use this little hose, and it's got a little clip on the side to clip it into place. Let's do that now. Trick is to thread this in so it comes out the back, okay? There, I've got it. Now we'll slide this on. I'm gonna put a little silicone spray on it. Hold on a second. This is this here. This is just to let it go on a little easier. Good. The nice thing about this is the bucket fits right inside, even with the tube in place. Let's go back to the boat. Now with the condenser and the evaporator in back, you'd think that the temperature of the air coming out this back area here would be room temperature, but actually it's not. It's mildly warm even without any external heater. Why is that? The answer calls into some interesting thermodynamics. I'm gonna let you pause the video and think about it. I'll tell you the answer later in the video. There are two reasons. Now, I don't know if you can hear it, but the wind is really howling today, so I'm gonna keep it fairly short. I've mounted this on the sink, and it's fortuitous that the wheels actually wedge themselves into the sink, so it's actually quite stable here. It's not going anywhere. In our marina, it's pretty quiet, and so I haven't got it tied on with anything else, but if your boat tends to rock in the marina, then obviously you'll need to tie it down further. Now here's the tube that drains right into the sink. Well, after a few days, these lines are crispy dry. Let's talk about how much it costs. To my surprise, the energy cost through the winter when we use this is a little less than $1 a day, and that's to charge the batteries as well. I think a big part of that is the fact that in such a small space, it doesn't take long to dry everything out. Once dried out, the humidity sensor in the device turns things off so it doesn't run continuously. There's all kinds of advantages to having a warm boat. You get better battery performance, you get less viscous engine oil, and so the chance of problems with starting is lower. And of course, the chance of plumbing disasters is lower as well. A heater should be more efficient at heating the boat, so why not just use a heater? So you saw in the video how the evaporator coils and the condenser coils are back to back. So as the air comes in, it cools and then warms. And so those two coils should largely cancel each other out. How is it that this device blows out mainly warm air? How does that work? All right, let's talk about that question. Let's think about it from the perspective of individual water molecules as they enter the boat. An individual water molecule that enters the boat will be so in a high energy state, gaseous state. And when that gas is drawn into the cold fins of the evaporator coil, it cools down and condenses into a liquid. And that cold liquid leaves the boat in a low energy state. And so what happens to the energy? They call that latent heat, the difference between the two. That energy ends up going into the fins and then the outgoing air. And so you get little packets of energy that are free energy as a result of the condensation that go into heating the boat. Now, the second factor is the motors. If you look at the amount of energy that a motor uses and compare it to the amount of work it does, most motors are about 30% efficient, and the rest of it is wasted as heat. Now, it's no surprise that these motors are both positioned near the outgoing airstream, and so the waste heat from those motors goes out with the waste air and is used to heat the boat. So it's a byproduct of what we're doing. So I think I've made a pretty good argument for the case that a dehumidifier is actually more effective and more efficient than a heater. A dehumidifier actually moves water out of the boat. It uses waste energy from motors and from latent heat of condensation to warm the boat, and it turns itself off when humidity targets are achieved. So I hope I've given you something to think about here. Thanks for watching.